Hi, I'm Ross Young. I work with Shell Albion Sands, Shell's oil sands operation. Shell Albion Sands' oil sands operation includes the Muskeg River and Jackpine mines. There has been a lot of interest around tailings and tailings ponds, so we thought it would be helpful to provide a short video which explains more about what tailings are, some of the challenges, and some of the things we're working on which will help us to reclaim these areas of our site faster. Oil sands are a mixture of bitumen, sand, silt, and clay materials. Once excavated, the oil sands go through an extraction process where warm water is added to wash the bitumen off the sand. Once the sand and other particles are removed, the bitumen is transported for upgrading and will eventually be used as a source of energy. With the bitumen removed, a mixture of water, small amounts of residual bitumen, sand, clay particles, small fines particles, and other solids are left. This combination is often referred to as tailings. The pipeline carrying tailings runs to a constructed dike or mined out area of the pit, which resembles a pond. Once the tailings are released within the dike, most of the water and lighter materials flow down the dike walls and into the tailings area. The sand contained in the tailings settles along the dike walls. 40 to 50% of the small fines particles are also captured here. Any sand and some of the small clay particles not captured on the dikes start to settle to the bottom of the pond, and water rises to the top. The rest stay suspended in the water, a challenge we will talk about later. The water that rises to the top is then recycled back into the plant for the extraction process. The ponds serve an important purpose as they allow the water to be reused, reducing our need for fresh water. We recycle about 80% of the water used in our mining operations. The quicker the tailings materials settle, the faster we can transform these tailings areas into reclaimed land. Due to the volume of water, external tailings ponds occupy a fair amount of land. To help reduce the amount of land needed, once mining is sufficiently advanced, tailings are placed in previously excavated areas of the mine. These are called in-pit tailings. Most operators are now able to use in-pit tailings areas to help reduce their land footprint. At Shell, we have one tailings pond for the Muskeg River mine and one for the Jackpine mine. Tailings can contain small amounts of unrecovered bitumen, which sometimes forms small patches on the surface of the ponds. The pond's surface area is mostly water. It's just the areas at the edges which can be prone to this bitumen. These patches could be a danger to birds and other animals if they try to land on them. Oil sand operators spend millions of dollars on world-class wildlife deterrent systems to minimize harm to animals in the area. Our bird deterrent systems have ensured that very few birds have landed in our tailings ponds. The very small fines particles, often referred to as mature fine tails, or MFT, aren't heavy enough to settle to the bottom of the pond and lie suspended in water for many years. Because of this, we call them fluid fines. Without assistance, these fluid fines would take many years to consolidate. Reducing the amount of these fluid fines has therefore become one of the biggest challenges for the industry. Accelerating their drying times means we can reclaim the tailings areas faster. Over the last 10 years, Shell has spent over $200 million on tailings technology and research. Key technologies we're currently working on include beaching, atmospheric fines drying, thickened tailings, as well as development of additional technologies for future years. When tailings come out of extraction and enter the ponds, most of the sand and a portion of the fines are captured in the dikes and beaches. The more fines we capture here, the better, as it reduces the amount of fines that become fluid. 40 to 50% of these fines are captured during beaching. At our Muskeg River mine, through technology application, even more of these fines have been captured, up to 65%. Atmospheric fines drying, or AFD, focuses on drying the fluid fines more quickly. For this to work, a dredge sits in the middle of our tailings pond and draws the fluid fines out. They're then transported to a drying area. Before they're placed in the drying area, The fines are mixed with a flocculant or thickener, which helps bind them together into larger particles. This thickened MFT is then spread in thin layers over the drying area. Because the fines are now more tightly bound, the water separates from the fines and drains off the surface. Once the fines have dried completely, further layers are placed on top. This approach results in the fines drying in a matter of weeks rather than years. Thickened tailings, or TT, is currently used exclusively by Shell. After extraction, instead of the tailings going straight to the tailings area, they go to a thickening plant. The design means a significant amount of water is drained off at the plant so that it can be recycled straight back into production. Because the water we drain off is still warm, we don't need to reheat it to the same degree as normal tailings water when it re-enters production. This means we save energy. Without the water, and with the addition of the flocculant, the tailings are much thicker as they travel to a dedicated disposal area. Here they are again spread in layers and allowed to consolidate. We hope this has helped you to better understand the tailings process and what Shell is doing to speed up the pace of reclamation. We're very proud of how far we've come, and we look forward to continuing to develop these and other technologies as we get on with the process of reclamation.